created the condition table. With the condition table, we create, correct? Then the access sequence is assigned to condition type. Then we had put all those condition types in the pricing procedure. And then for the combination of sales area, document pricing procedure and customer pricing procedure, I assigned the pricing procedure. Okay, for this combination, the system determined, okay, this is the pricing procedure I have to use. Okay. So, yesterday there was, yeah. That assignment was. I wanted to show you that assignment. Okay. Basic functions. Pricing. For the combination of 1000 and 00, my document pricing procedure was A, customer pricing procedure was 1. Okay, A is 01, PR 00. Now it must work. RVB01. Anyway, you could have changed it pretty instead of waiting for it. Come on, anyway, it is a sandbox system. You can always find out, okay, it's not a production system, so critical, like, if I make any changes, that will affect the business. Nothing like that. Okay, that is why I told you, everybody, to create your own document types. Okay, in the document type, okay, right now, for OR, we are using the document pricing procedure A. For you, okay, somebody assigned some X, Y, Z, okay. So, for the combination of 1000, document pricing procedure X, and customer pricing procedure 1, you can assign your newly created or your own pricing procedure. So, that is the intention of asking you people to maintain your own document type. Okay. So, yesterday one thing we have been seeing very often, like condition types. So, by the time without knowing what the configurations for condition types are, we got familiar with this condition type. Isn't it true? So, today you will see what the condition type is. Okay. So, you have noticed the pricing. Okay. So let me go to VA01 and create a sales order. So, what is the value of the sales order? It is 395 plus taxes. Okay. So, we had seen how the pricing is being calculated. Okay. So, what are the type of components in this pricing? We have one is the condition type. One condition type is my pricing. Another condition type is AZWR, that is down payment or settlement. Third one is MWSP, that is tax. Fourth one is SCTO, that is cash discount. And fifth one is VPRS, cost. So already we have so many types of discounts, condition types. Not discounts, so many conditions of condition types. My one condition type is here, price. My one condition type is here, tax. My one condition type is here, discount. And my one condition type is here, down payment entry. And my one condition type is here, cost. So there are almost 5 types of condition types available. That is discounts or surcharges. We have prices. We have taxes. In the taxes, we have another one, wage withholding tax. And the final one is the expenses reimbursement, that is the rebates. Okay. So, whatever the condition types we create for pricing, they fall within these 5 categories. Okay. So, we are going to say, you can see one condition type is defined in percentage. Okay. Your tax and discounts are defined in percentage. Okay. But your price is defined in the absolute value. So, what if I want to define a discount in absolute value, which means that for each piece I want to give €1 free, I mean €1 discount. I mean, like here we have defined the discount in percentage. So, what if I want to define the discount in absolute value? So, those kind of things we are going to see in the configuration right now. So, let us go to IMG. Maintain condition types. Let us start with our most used and most familiar one, that is the price PR00. So this is also very similar to our order type configuration or item category configuration. So this is the place as a sequence. This is the place you can see where you have assigned your newly created access sequences to. Okay. So in our order type we used to say whether this order type is a order or inquiry or quotation or something. Similarly, here in condition class we say whether this is a price or discount or taxes are reimbursement, so whatever it could be. So, in our case, PR00 is a price. So, we have maintained it as price. Then is a calculation type. On what basis we are calculating it? Which means, whether we are calculating for quantity, or whether we are calculating for volume, or whether we are calculating for some other parameter. So, value or weight or something. So, we are calculating the prices on quantity basis. That is why we say like 395 euro per piece. Okay. Then, we come to the condition category. So, for example, we are saying whether this condition category belongs to, there is a difference between class and category. Okay. So, whether this category belongs to taxes or discounts or something. So, then we have the rounding rule. Actually, there are 2 places you can define the rounding rules. One at the material level, which means material level or condition type level, which means you say, so when my price comes to 7.23 euros, I have to round it to 7.25 euros. Or sometimes people used to ignore the complete this 25 paise. Now in India we have abolished the 25 paise. There is no 25 paise anymore. We have only 50 paise and 1 rupee. So in such cases 7.23 must either come to 7 or it must come to 7.5. So these kind of rounding are there. So if you have defined, so normally this rounding rule is defined at the company code level by the finance people because we are getting the invoices and other things. So, they normally define the rounding profile at the company code level. Else, the materials management people are there. So, they do the rounding. Price rounding they do. So, how it has to be rounded to. If you just leave it as the commercial here, the system will take whatever is defined at the top level, whether it is the company code level or the material level. Then you have the plus or minus. Whether this value is having a positive value or negative value. Normally for discounts we used to have the negative value. And for the surcharges, like your additional surcharges for if the consignment crosses certain weights, or your in case of electricity or EB billing or water billing. So we here in India we used to have something called as penalty class. If you cross over 200 power units of consumption, then they used to slap you with a fine for excessive usage of penalty, excessive usage, saying that okay, even though we are paying it on time, so they are saying that we are using too much of power, which is to discourage that they are leaving the penalty class. So in those kind of surcharges will be having the positive value. So I can explicitly say whether it is positive only or negative only, or I can leave it blank so that when creating the condition records, I can say whether it could be a positive value or negative value. So that is what. If I leave it blank, I can, when I am creating the condition records, I can explicitly mention whether it is going to be a positive one or negative one. Then we have the structure condition. Structure condition means like how this condition type can be used in your pricing process. For example, you must have noticed that your condition type has been used only once in the pricing procedure, but sometimes the SAP is, I haven't come across this scenario, but SAP is giving you a provision that you can use the same condition type in your pricing procedure more than once. If you want to do that, you can enable this. Okay. Then comes our group condition. Okay. So let me say one example. You are having a store and you are saying if anybody buys over 100 pieces of soap, let me say like toilet soap, they will be getting a 20% discount. If anybody crosses 100 pieces of soap, they will be getting 20% discount. Okay. So now one customer comes in, he is taking 50 pieces of Lux and 50 pieces of hammam. Okay. Do this customer get a discount? Because he hadn't taken 100 pieces in any of that. Even though the cumulative value is 100, so he had taken only 50 pieces of hammam, but I am saying if anybody crosses 100, then he will be getting that discount. So if he wants, technically speaking, the customer is not entitled for a discount because he hadn't crossed the 100 pieces in any of that. But if I think logically, why should a customer buy 100 pieces of only one brand just for the sake of discount? So I can say, make a group condition saying that anybody who buys this condition material that belongs to a material group called as soap. If you go to material master MM02, in the sales organization 1 tab, you can find the material group. And sales organization 2, you can find the pricing group. Okay. So you can say like, anybody who buys the material group soap or material pricing group soap, they must get the discount, which means the customer need not buy one single brand to get that benefit. He can buy multiple brands, but once the quantity reaches that 100, he will be getting that discount or benefit. Okay. So if you want to enable this kind of thing, not only in these soaps, this grouping is used in freights also. Because in the freight is normally calculated based on your weight and volume. So let me say suppose your sales order has 5 items, okay, and each item is having 20 kgs, 30 kgs, 10 kgs, 40 kgs and 50 kgs. So totally 150 kgs. But when your freight forwarder is calculating the cost, he will be telling on the kg basis, kilogram basis, but he doesn't bother about how many pieces or how many different types of articles you have. So only he is bothered about if your containment crosses so and so value, then this is my freight rate. Okay. So the system automatically combines or groups all the values in your sales order, all the weight of all the values in the sales order, and then it takes you and then it applies the price defined for per kg in the sales order. Okay. So in freight, in discounts, in sometimes even for your rebates also, because if you have promised your customer that if you have crossed the so and so quantity, so and so value, then I will give you 1% additional rebate or something like that. Okay. So in such cases, the system has to group all your materials in the sales order and then take the appropriate value. So that is the group condition. I mean, like for us, the PR00, that is the price of an article, is not a group condition, so it is not enabled as of now. Then is the round difference component. What happens is, like, when you group everything and finally you get, let me say in terms of value, after adding all your values, the system finds out the total value of the sales order becomes 180.13 euro. Okay. So now you can, if you maintain something called as factoring discount, then the system will knock off the 0.13 and it will explicitly say factoring discount is 0.13 and it will round up your value to 180. Okay. So if your condition type is a rounding difference condition type, then you have to enable it here. Okay. Then is the group condition routine. Now we had seen almost 2-3 scenarios in the group condition. One is for freight calculating and one is for your discount calculating and one is for rebate calculating. So while calculating the rebate, I mean the values, how, of course, the system groups together. That is fine. That is one thing we had easily understood. Let me say, for the first article, if I buy 10 pieces, I will be getting 5% discount. But if I cross 100 pieces, I will be getting 10% discount. Okay. Similarly, for article 2, if I buy normally, I buy 5% discount, but if I cross 100 pieces, I will be getting some 15% discount. So, my first article was, my first article is 50 pieces and second article is another 50 pieces. If I calculate the discounts individually, I will be giving only 10% for first article and 5% for second article because they didn't reach that 100 slab. But if I take the group condition, which means the quantity put together is 100, even though the individual quantities are not 100, the cumulative quantity is 100, which means now these articles are eligible to have the articles, I mean a discount of the slab 100, which means now the first article will get 20% and second article will get 15%. So that is defined by the across all condition types. If you enable the group condition 2, system will calculate the value up like this. Okay. Similarly, I mean, in this case, the system calculated all the materials even though they didn't belong to the same group. So, if I enabled the group condition number 3, the system will take the materials that belong to same condition group, cumulate it, and then apply scale to that. It doesn't take all the materials in your sales order. It takes the materials that belong to same material pricing group, and then only it will apply that. Okay. And the third one is the total document. Total document value is for your header discounts or something. If the total earns, you are freight forwarding also. What is there for the whole document, you take that and then apply the value for that. Okay. So these are all the group condition routines. And in our case, PR00 is not a group condition, so we haven't entered anything. Okay. Now I go back to my sales order. Just now I had entered the PR00 value manually because the condition writer was not existing. Now else I overwrite it. Okay, so which means I am able to make the manual changes. Okay, how this is being controlled? So that is given in the changes which can be managed, which can be made block. It says manual entry has the priority. And so that is why if I was able to make any changes, the system takes it. Let me change it to not able to process manually. Let me change it. Come back. So in that case, I have to maintain the week 11 first. Week 11, PR00, material release status, 1010, T-8101, is my 395, in the rows 30. Okay, the system takes the value 395. Suppose if I want to change the price, I go to the condition. Can you see the PR00 is grayed out right now, which means I cannot enter the values manually. This is because just now I made the condition type as not able to process manually. So let me revert it back to C. Okay. Then, whether it is a header condition or item condition. Header conditions are normally, there is thumb rule, okay. The header condition doesn't have a access sequence. Unless you have to enter the header conditions manually in the header. On what kind of scenarios you give the header conditions? So let me say if the sales order value crosses $1,000, then I can give 2% discount. Or if the sales order value crosses 500 euros, then I can give 5% discount. So these kind of things. So when you say the sales order value, which means it is the sum of all the value of all the items. So it is the sum of all items in your item level. So that is taken into header. So you cannot define those values in the item level, so which has to be done at the header level. So you have to define whether it is a header condition or item condition. Sometimes you can enable it as both as header and item condition. Okay. Then here comes your amount or percentage. So this is like whether this value which you have defined, it can be changed while you are creating the value. While you are creating the sales order, whether you can change the value of this condition record. Okay. Whether it is possible to delete this condition record or not, that is enabled here, and then it is the okay. In that case, previous value we had said it is the percentage, whether you can change the value of the condition record here. Okay. Then whether you have to use alternative calculation type, or you have, if you want to use the quantity relation in the sense like conversion factor. We normally say 10 pieces make 1 car time. Okay, so if you want these conversion factors to be calculated using, I mean, if you want to define some other formulas for your calculation, then you have to enable that. Let me say, for example, there are two items. Okay, item A 50 pieces, item B is 50 pieces. So I am leaving a $10 freight for these items. I mean, like, ideally speaking, you can split into $5 for item A, $5 for item B, because their the quantities remains the same. Okay. Let me change the value. The item A has 750 kgs and item 2 has 250 kgs. Okay. If I want to calculate the freight, or I want to distribute that freight $10 among them, then if I take the kg basis, and that is kilogram basis, then item A will draw $7.5 as freight and item B will draw $2.5 as this freight. Okay. So first I took the quantity, second I took the weight. Now if I go for value, let me say my 750 kgs is equal to $2,000 worth, or $200 worth, whereas the item B, even though it is 250 kg only, it is worth for $800. Okay. Now if I want to split my freight cost based on value, then item A will draw $2 as freight charge and item B will draw $8 as freight charge. So the article quantity was the same, okay, but it differed on the weight and value. Okay, similarly you can do the same thing for your volume also. So based on which parameter you have to determine your freight value. So that you have to mention it here. If you want to make it as quantity relationship, which means like if I want to calculate only on based on the quantities, not else, then you have to enable this. If you want to enter another calculation type, that is what we discussed about the freight and weight and volume and value, you have to enable this here. And you can give this formula for this in your pricing procedure. Okay. Then we have the, when you create the master data, you have seen the system had taken the validity date from today and to eternity, that is 31/12/999. But if I want to, I don't want to give the validity for so long, I want to restrict it to whether end of this month or end of this year or end of only for today's date, you have to enable it here. So based on this only, the system will take the validity period when it is creating the condition records. Okay. Reference condition type is like, sometimes this condition type will take value from some other condition type. Okay. That way, when such scenario comes, we will discuss that. Then we have enabled something called as condition index. Condition index means like, if you enable indexing this condition type, then the system will, similar to the indexing functionality in your databases. So you create something as index field in your database, so that when you are searching the database, the system, based on the index values, the system fetches the appropriate records quickly. Similarly, here I am saying, I want the system to index these condition records for this condition type. I want the system to index the condition records for this condition type, so that when somebody searches the value, it must be taken up quickly. So that is why I enable the condition index. Then there is something called as condition update. Condition updates are normally used in your discounts. For example, you are saying, okay, I am giving 2% discount for article A. Provided, I can give only discount for first 100 pieces for first 3 sales orders. Okay. So, there has to be some update. The system has to update the value. So, whenever you are raising the sales order for article A, the system will update the quantity in the condition update. It is saying once the quantity crosses 100 pieces, then the system will stop giving the discounts for that particular article. To enable that functionality or feature, so we use the condition update scale. Then is our scale basis. Scales are like when you are, if you want to define multiple pricing or variable pricing for more than, so for example, like just now I created the VK11 or PR00 for article 101 as 395 pieces per euro. If I want this, okay, let me get into that itself. /NVK12 PR00 metal status. So as of now, the price is 395. I want to give you a special price for anybody who crosses 25 pieces or 50 pieces. Okay. So I click this blue button, that is the scale. So I am saying from 26 rupees, I want to give a price of. What if I try to give 400? The system will say must be smaller than the preceding value, because in my condition type I had told made the value as check value as descending, which means the value must be coming in the descending order. So I have to maintain the value less than 395. So let me put it as 380. And whomever buys after 50 pieces, so they must get the price of 370. So this is my scales. So when I am giving the scales, now you had seen on what basis I am giving these scales. I am giving the scales based on quantity, and I am setting the values in the descending order. Okay. Then there is something called the scale type. I don't know about the billing in US for telephones, but in India we have this telephone rates, like from 1 to 100 calls it will be 75 paisa per unit. Okay. From 101 to 200 the cost is 1.25 rupees per call. Okay. What is the pricing followed there? Similar one, or it will, I mean, like once it crosses the slab it's taken as a flat rate. Pardon? From mobiles? Okay. Is there any slab for that also? After 3000 minutes, up to 5000, anything like that? Yeah, of course, here also there are different plans. Okay, like what I'm... Okay. Okay, so I mean, if I use the 6000 minutes that particular month, okay, how my charge will be taken? Up to 3000 it is free, so my value is for the 3000 is 0. Okay, so remaining 3000 has to be calculated. Am I right? Okay, so to do that functionality, we have something called as graduated scale. Graduated to interval scale. Okay. So the system goes, takes the values based on the scale, not on the flat rate. For example, in this scenario for which I am defining the price, if any of my customer orders, let me say 100 pieces, okay, there are two ways of pricing. One is, if he orders 100 pieces, so the system must take the value 370 into 100, okay, because it is exceeding the 51 pieces. But if you want the telephone type of calculation, then I use the graduated to scale interval. Okay, here in the scale size, I have to maintain it as graduated to interval scale, and then the system will take the value. If anybody buys 100 pieces of this article, so he will be charged for first 10 pieces 395. So 395 into 10. Okay. For 10 pieces, first 25 pieces, he will be charged at 395. The next 25 will be charged at 380. Then the remaining 50 will be charged at 370. So then what will be my cost now? So that is 395 into 20. 395 into 25, so 9875. Then you have 380 into 25, that is 9500. Then 370 into remaining 50. So now my overall value becomes 37,875. But if I maintain the simple value, that is the flat rate, if anybody crosses 51, then the value will be 370, which means 370 into 100, it will be 37,000. Okay. But if you calculate based on scale, it is 37,875. So most of the times, like, you are in the industry sector, this will be the kind of pricing. Okay, they will be saying, like, if anybody crosses, I want the price to be done on slabs. So these kind of things are there. Okay. So this is now controlled by the scale type. If you leave it blank, the system will take the price which is found in the appropriate slab. Else if you make it as graduated to, then it will take, calculate for each slab quantity. Okay. So let us see the another condition type. So let me say one discount type. KA series are always the customer discount type, and K0 number series are the material types, normally material discount types. So let me say KA00 is my promotion. So it says this is not a price, this is a condition or discount. So the class is assigned as A, and this is calculated by the percentage basis. If you want to make it as absolute value basis, then you can choose the fixed amount. Okay. This is a discount, so it has a negative value. This is not a group discount, okay, so we are not changing anything. As usual, it is a value scale. Here it is the value scale, not the quantity scale, which means you have to define the percentage, saying like, if the value crosses so and so, then you have to give this kind of discount value. Okay, so this is the discount value. Okay. As usual, this has a condition record. So let me take one header discount, HA00, percentage discount. HA is percentage and HB is value, so you see both. HA is a header discount. Okay. It is a header discount, so it doesn't have any access sequence. Okay. I can either make it as a positive, that is a discount, or I can make it as a surcharge, as a penalty for using more than the needed resources. Okay, so that is why I am leaving it as positive and negative. Okay. It is a discount of success and I calculate it based on the percentage. Since it is a group 1, I mean assigned in the header, it has to calculate for the values for all your items. So that is why it is a group condition. Okay. I don't want to calculate on anything, so I just want to take the overall value. So I didn't mention any routings. I don't want to use any rounding. No limitations for entering or manipulating the value. Okay. Here there is no scale, no seek value, nothing like that. Okay. If I go to HB00, it is similar one, but only thing is that will be a fixed amount. Can you see? It is a discount, but it is a fixed amount. That is the only change. Everything remains the same. So we had seen one discount, we had seen one price. So let us see our normal calculation, that is the NWST tax calculation. It is a tax calculated in percentage, could be both positive or negative value, and my condition category is defined as tax. So there is no condition category defined when we use the price PR00. Okay. This has to take value of all the items in the sales order, so it is a group condition. You cannot process the taxes manually. So if you go to the VA01, you can see that the value is automatically proposed. You cannot manipulate MWST. And you cannot delete the MWST also. So let me show that. /NVA01 order quantity 1. Okay. Cannot be processed manually because that is 1. So, if I try to, I cannot edit anything. Okay. Since I had told that it's not able to process manually, if I try to change anything, no. If I try to delete also, it will say the condition type cannot be processed manually. So, that is why. That is the function it has taken it. Okay. You want the system to maintain index for this. Okay. You want the system. You don't want to update for this. Okay. So you need that. Okay. But this has a condition access sequence assigned to that. Okay. So now you must be having an idea what a condition type is. So in SAP, like the condition type, the definition goes like condition type or condition type is the base value or formula on which the values or condition records are calculated. That is the definition SAP gives for this. Okay. So let us go to the pricing procedure. So in the pricing procedure we had seen that what is our standard pricing procedure? RV AA01. I select that. I go to control data. Okay, this and that I can understand. Okay, I'm entering the condition type, but what is this so long? Almost 16 columns will be there. Okay, so let us see. First one is the step. The step says in which sequence you want to the system to process the condition types. Okay. So, once again, it must be assigned in the logical fashion. So, which means like, your prices must be put together. So, based on the price, you want to calculate the discounts. So, first block will be the prices, second block will be the discounts, and third block will be your taxes, fourth one will be the freight, and fifth one will be the rebate basis, and the last one is your total. Okay. So you have to arrange the condition types on some logical fashion. So that is why you use the functionality called steps. As if you had noticed, we had given some provision in some places, okay, to maintain the, I mean, there is some gap. Immediately after 8, we had 11. We didn't start with 0 or 1, which means I can enter, if I want to enter some other condition types before EK01, I can do that. So I have given that provision. Similarly, after EK01, before PR00, if I want to enter anything new, I can do that. Only to have this functionality or to have a provision to add condition types at a later time, I we are giving the intervals for creating the, giving the step numbers. Okay. Then is the counter. So what is this counter is used for? Well, for example, let me say I have 2 discounts for that customer, which means for customer specific discount I am giving some 5%, and the material specific discount I am giving another 5%. So let me say my price is $100. Okay. So first the price is $100, then the system calculates the customer discount 5% based on the price. Okay. So the discount is calculated, and the second line the step value that becomes 100 minus 5, that is 95. Now I want to apply the material discount. On which value this material discount must be assigned, calculated on, whether it is on the material price or on the second line. Can somebody answer? The second discount is there. Okay. So the material price is 100. First in the, that is the first line. In the second line I am giving the customer discount 5%, which means the value becomes 95. In the third line I am giving the material discount 5%. Whether this 5% must be calculated on the customer the first $100, or it has to be calculated on the previous line, that is 95. It is 100. If you want the system to calculate value on 100, then the both discount must be put in the same step and differentiated with a counter. If you come down, can you see there are a series of discounts in step 110. Okay. And the system takes the value from, the system calculates the discount from the step number 100. So what is my step number 100? That is going to be the gross price. The gross value. Okay. So you have the same step. So okay, like you can even put it simple. When you use, if you want to use the same step number for various condition types, then you can differentiate using the counter. In this case, my RA01 will be calculated for 100, that is the gross value. My RA00 is also calculated for 100, because it is in the same step, but differing only in the counter. So, if I don't mention this 1, 2, 3, 4 in counters, but if I make it as 110, 111, the system will calculate, the step number 111 will calculate the discount based on the step 110. Okay. So that is why, if you, to simplify things, what are all the discounts you want to apply at the same level, you put them in a same step, but differentiate with the counter. Okay. Then comes your condition types. Here you are entering the condition types. Then the description is automatically taken from your condition type descriptions. Okay. Then is the from value and to value. why this from and to are taken. For example, like if you want to, you may want to find out in the invoice, so what is going to be my only discounts, which means I have to sum up all my discount condition types only. So this is my step 300. It says the discount amount is equal to the sum of the values found between the steps 101 up to 299. So all my discount starts at 101. Okay. So that is why here in the sum and to value I have said calculate or sum up all the discount values that between the steps 101 to 299. Then the system will create an so if you say go for invoice creation. Okay, we'll go to here itself. Okay, can you see the total? The system had created a line called as total. What is this total? This is the sum of these values: your price, output tax, and down payment settlements. Okay, so this is how this total has come. It is the sum of your previous. Let me say this is the step number 8 up to step number 99. My total is the sum of step number 8 to 99 that is being defined here. Then you have the manual, required, and statistical. Manual discount means you have to enter the values manually. And required discount is required is this value must be there in your sales order. When you are creating the values, this value must be there. Just now we have seen that when we are trying to create the sales order value, the system said mandatory condition PR00 is missing. How did the system know whether it is a mandatory one? That is because here I have entered it as a required entry. That is why the system found that this is a mandatory one. Then comes the tab called as statistical. If I come to the sales order, okay, what is my value? This is 395 plus 63.2. Okay, so my value is 458.20. Okay, but I have something called as cash discount and VTRS value. So put together this value comes to 294 something. So but the 294 is not added to any of this value. Okay. Because they are present in the sales order but they doesn't contribute anything towards the addition or depreciation of the values in the sales order. Okay. They are there for the statistical purpose. For this SKTO, I am saying if the customer is paying within 14 days, then he will be getting an additional 3% discount. I am saying if you pay within 14 days, if the customer pays within 14 days, then the system will activate this cash discount and this 13.75 discount will be allowed. If the customer is not paying within that 13 days or 14 days, then the system won't give that discount. So until it is being applied, it is in the system, in the invoice as a statistical value. That is, it doesn't add or subtract the value. Similarly is your cost. Why I had entered the cost here? Because I want to calculate the profit margin. That is the only purpose I have entered the cost. This 309 is not added to anything. Okay, this 309 influenced the sales order value in no way. Okay, so but it is there for statistical purposes, which means only when I enter this VTRS, then the system will be able to find out, okay, this is my purchasing cost and this is my selling cost, so this is my profit margin. So only to calculate the profit margin, we have entered the VTRS. There is no other purpose or functionality for that. So it is a statistical value. So statistical value, in simple terms, you can say like it will be present in the sales order, but for some purposes, but it won't have any effect on the value of the sales order. That is the statistical value. Then you have the print. What are the, you have so many fields. Okay. So when you are creating an invoice for your customer, what are the things that has to be printed? So that is marked in the X here. Then you have the subtotal. Obviously, when we are grouping the values of certain condition types, we must be grouping it for some purposes, which means that grouped value must be updated in some information system. For example, this gross value is taken to this sum table. Okay, and let me come down for net value for item. It is taken to calculate the value and take to the credit management system. For example, okay, this is my total. Total is taken to my credit management system. Okay. So this subtotal, so whenever you group for, what is this D? D must be taken to the discount account. So whenever you are grouping some the values of some condition type, obviously it has to be taken or it has to be updated in some sales information system. In the subtotal, you define the routines which do that functionality. Here the routine number 1 says that it is going to take the carry over the value to table KOMP and update the field KZVI1. Then you have the requirements. What is the requirement we had already? Have you seen? Requirement means the system must satisfy a set of conditions before executing or carrying out some activities. For example, here we always maintain this requirement number 2, which means we say if this item is relevant for pricing, then execute this. Where we have maintained this item is relevant for pricing, we maintain it in our item category, sales order item category. If this article is having a item category TAN, and if TAN is marked for pricing, then you carry out this price. If the item is not marked for pricing, then don't carry out this value. So that is the meaning of this requirement. Then is your calculation type. Calculation type is what we talked sometime back in the group condition routine. So when you have the values, for example, the system automatically calculates the, let me say, your quantity relationship. 10 pieces make 1 carton. That is your normal formula. But if you want the system to calculate some other value, for example, let me take that freight example itself. Article A is 50 pieces, article B is 50 pieces. Okay. But they differ in weight, value, and volume. So on which basis you want the system to calculate the value for this condition type, that you have to define it here. By default, there will be a normal one which you are defining while calculating the condition records itself. If you want the system to calculate a different value, then you have to use the different routines for this calculation type. Similarly, the system calculates the base value based on your condition records. But if you want the base value to be calculated differently, for example, you had defined 2% as your rebate accrual, okay, your rebate condition. But you are saying, I have to calculate this only when a certain value or certain quantity has been reached, which means, to make it still more simpler, I could say, free goods. I am saying, if anybody buys 2 pieces of article A, I will give them 1 piece of article B free, okay, but with a condition, It's not for everybody. Whomever buys more than 10 pieces of article A, they will be eligible for this discount. Which means if somebody buys 8 pieces of article A, they won't get any free goods. But if somebody buys 12 pieces of article A, they will be getting 6 pieces of article B as free goods. So I have defined some condition record and I have a different base value. Here my base value or base volume is 10. Okay. If anybody crosses that 10 only, they will be eligible for the discount or free goods. Okay. So in case of having different base types or base volume or base value, then I have to enter this here. Most of the cases you won't be having, only in rare cases you will be. So you don't bother much about this calculation type as well as the base value type. Then if you are accrual key. So whenever you are making a sale, you have noticed that there are various components like your price, your discounts, you have taxes, and you have something called as down payment. Okay, so it's not like the whole this what is the value, whole value 458.2. It's not that 458.2 will go into the single account. Instead, it will be split into various accounts. I mean various components, that is your price, tax and discount, and it will be updated in the different GL accounts. To find, for enabling the system to find out which GL account this particular condition type value has to be posted, that is determined using the account key. Like our price determination, we have an account determination. We will see that at a later time. Anyway, account determination goes like company code plus sales organization plus account key plus material account group plus customer account assignment group. For this combination, the system will find out one GL account and it will be posted to that only. Okay. Then the last one is the accruals. Accruals are normally used only in the rebates. So you cannot find them populated, but only for the rebate conditions. So based on how account key determines the GL account, similarly, accruals key find out the appropriate intermediate rebate related GL accounts. Rebate means like it is a sort of conditional discount. The discounts normally flow in the sales order itself. Even though rebate is a discount, it doesn't flow in your sales order directly. Instead, it is taken to some hypothetical or intermediate account. It's saying like this customer had bought $100,000 worth of goods and he is eligible for $7,000 rebate. Okay. So you hadn't given that $7,000 to your customer even though he is eligible to. You didn't give that $7,000 while creating the sales order itself. So you are keeping it separately and running it in a separate transaction and settling it at either once in a year or once in 3 months or sometimes even once in a month. Okay. So to do that, the system has to determine a special GL account to which this rebate accrual has to be posted to, and this accrual key helps you in determining that. So this is the famous 16 step 3, 6, 9, 12. This is the famous. Okay. So you have to, I mean, like initially it may look so many, initially you may feel intimidated, like there are so many fields, I don't know how to understand that. But once you start coming into the screen more often, that is, you create your own pricing procedures, you create your own condition types, and then you come to the screen, then you will understand, okay, this is what it is that. Okay. So until then, like, it will be some sort of intimidating. You have to really need that. So this is the pricing procedure as well as the condition type. Yeah. 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 For that, you have to define different condition types. you have to create different condition tables, different condition types. So you can either use the standard condition type or you can copy them and modify to your needs. Okay. So with this, so tomorrow we'll see the condition exclusion, and then we will move to the other aspects of pricing like promotions and sales deals. Okay. I will upload the file now. Okay, once this class is over, I can initiate the upload.